Hi there. In this video, I want to go over seven different ways you can use to find open job vacancies. And we're going to be making use of our resources on our website. That's the Pharma job hunting resources for both Ireland and the UK. We also have one for the US as well too. So we often find that people default to just using one or two or three methods. For example, applying for advertised job positions on the jobs board, using a headhunter or recruitment agency, or maybe just applying for a position on LinkedIn. But there are lots of other ways you can use to find jobs besides just those two or three methods. So let's jump in. So first of all, what we want to do is we want to navigate to our job hunting resource page. And as mentioned, we've got one for Ireland, one for the UK, one for the US, focus around the Pennsylvania area. But to be honest with you, the methods apply no matter what country you're in. So even if you aren't in Ireland, the UK or the US, you should still check out these resource centers. So here we are. And the very first method is to apply for advertised vacancies. And probably one of the easiest ways you can do this if you're in Ireland is to go to our own jobs board. And we update this usually two times a month. So for example, you can pick any particular sector. For example, it could be production and manufacturing. And we list all the jobs down here. But in addition to our own jobs board, we've also listed other jobs boards that you can go and check out as well. For example, Indeed, Irish Jobs, Monster and the like. And the second method would be speculative job applications. And we break down the process here. So the idea is that you send out your CV or resume to a company, even though they don't have any advertised positions that you'd be suitable for. So the idea is that your CV happens to land on the desk of a manager who's thinking about hiring somebody or is already in the middle of hiring somebody, but is sitting on a bunch of applications and hasn't moved forward with it. So we generally recommend that you send out one speculative job application for every two advertised positions you apply for. And again, we've broken down the process here. Check out this article where we break it down step by step. We've listed out every single pharmaceutical and medical device factory in the country, so you can use that as a way to develop your seed list. We also have a Google map as well too. And we also have built out a directory of every pharmaceutical company, engineering consultancy, recruitment agencies, contract services companies as well. And that can also help you when it comes to developing your seed list of companies to apply for. The third method is to use a recruitment company. This tends to work best for those who already have a lot of job experience. It doesn't seem to work as well for those who are novices or are brand new to the sector. A fourth method would be to use a contract services company. And again, we've listed the main ones here in Ireland. So these companies hire you directly and then place you within a client pharmaceutical or medical device company. The client pays them and then the contract services company pays you. Now, it can often be easier to get your first job within the sector using these companies, and they can offer a great way to build your experience. We've certainly seen a lot of people move from working within a contract services company to getting hired directly by the client company as well too. Although one of the drawbacks or downsides can be that your salary may not be quite as high as the equivalent position if you're working directly for the company. But again, that depends on the specific area you're working in. A fifth method can be to use or to apply for jobs with engineering consultancies. And this is an excellent path, especially for anybody with a chemical or process, petrochemical, project, validation, automation, electrical, mechanical, maintenance, plant, or environmental engineering backgrounds, or even civil engineering backgrounds as well too. So in contrast to working directly for a pharma or medical device company, on ongoing internal projects, you'd be more likely to work on large-scale capital projects. This type of work tends to pay really well, often with significant opportunities for overtime. The work is often more varied too, but you have to move from project to project, and your long-term work schedule will be far less predictable. A sixth method can be to use social media. LinkedIn, of course, is the major player here. LinkedIn, again, is a professional network whose entire function is to connect people based on their professional experience and goals. So we've listed some links here to get you started, but this is an excellent method to use when it comes to finding work in this sector. We've also listed out some relevant LinkedIn groups too. And last but not least, the seventh method is networking with pharma industry professionals. And again, as the saying goes, it's not what you know, it's who you know. And if you want to get started on this method, again, it's often overlooked by a lot of people, but we really do recommend that you go through these links. It can be an excellent method as well. Well, I hope you found that useful. Thank you very much for watching.